super hot here. So my partner and I, we set up some shade to help cool off our neighborhood and keep everybody safe.
It's already bad enough not having air conditioning, but to have no power at all in this heat is dangerous.
Hey, Sal?
Yeah?
Do you have my car keys? Where are they?
I might have left them in the car.
In the car? The car is open? Where in the car? Oh my God. I'm going to the dealership. Don't let Jack distract you next time.
Amelia, I was grocery shopping.
With Jack.
Who said that?
It was me.
My car?
Yep, and I know where the keys are.
Well, where are they?
Why don't you tell me where we're going first? We're going to the dealership, aren't we?
Look, I'm sorry.
No. You don't need to apologize.
No, but like now I feel weird about it.
This is bound to happen, you know. It's natural.
This isn't how I wanted you to find out.
Well, hey, at least tell me who the new guy is, huh?
I've been looking, but nothing feels right so far. I thought I could just go to the dealership and see what they have to say. Maybe they can help me.
Well, what about one of those new electric cars? Have you thought of one of those?
You're trying to get me to buy a Tesla from Elon Musk?
No, it's not like you could afford it anyways.
Excuse me?
I don't know why I said that. What I meant to say was that there are plenty of other options for EVs.
Even so, you know how in the news recently they've been showing how they're not even any better for the environment? The batteries are still bad. And it doesn't even matter in the first place, because our electricity comes from burning fossil fuels. Look, just where are the keys?
What? No. I'm not going to let you go to the dealership thinking EVs are bad. First of all, EVs are better for the environment than gas cars. A study from Cambridge has shown that in 95% of the world, the usage of EVs emit less than gas-powered cars. And Yale confirms that EVs have less of a net carbon footprint. And yes, while manufacturing EVs may initially emit more than those gas cars, over their lifetime, EVs prove to emit significantly less. Just ask researchers from Yale University and check out the Environmental Protection Agency. Sustainability of EVs and even the ethics of their sourcing are improving day by day. But gas cars will never get any better, and sticking to them contributes to not just us, but future generations not being able to live healthy and safe lives.
Wait, slow down, I lost you. Ethical sourcing? What does that even mean? Is that like the workers and the factories and like the, how is everything made?
Well, for ethical sourcing, companies like Ford and the federal government are actually investing $3.7 billion into U.S. factories that produce electric vehicles right here in our country. This will also create over 6,200 union jobs in the United States. And if this goes well, another $1 billion will be invested into improving working conditions in other similar factories. These investments can go a long way in helping workers not only get jobs, but also have great working conditions.
Well, do you know any electric vehicles that would be good? I just graduated, and I really didn't think an electric vehicle would fit into my budget.
Look, I hear you. There are many affordable brands that are transitioning to electric vehicles. Volvo, Volkswagen, GM, and Cadillac all plan to be fully electric by 2030. Additionally, Honda, Toyota, Kia, and Ford are all planning to make big changes in the coming years as well. You'll have plenty of options to choose from when picking an electric vehicle. It's not just all Tesla.
Okay, I can see that. But what about charging it and taking care of it? That sounds like a pain. And I heard the electric grid wouldn't even be able to handle that many electric vehicles. Do we even have the capacity for that?
And concerns over the electric grid assume that all EVs would be charging at once, which just won't happen. As for the maintenance, they're way easier than gas cars. Way easier.
No more oil changes.
No more oil changes.
Okay. Let me just see if I've gotten all of this down. So, contrary to popular belief, electric vehicles are less expensive than most people think. And turns out a bunch of car manufacturers are planning on or already have gone electric. Long term, they're better for the environment than gas cars in 95% of the world, and that's apparently backed up by Yale and Cambridge. The federal government and major automation companies are dedicated to fund billions of dollars to have unionized electric vehicle factories in the US, which would, of course, open up thousands of new jobs while maintaining the automation jobs that already exist. You know, it's hard to see where I fit exactly into the whole, like, sustainability, save the earth, fight for the future generation. But I really think sitting down and listening to you, I think it helped. Hey, are you okay?
Yeah, no, I'm okay. It's just we've been through so much together, you know? High school, college. Remember all those stupid bumper stickers you used to stick on me? Listen, I know it's overwhelming, I just want what's best for you. I won't be here forever, you know, and I don't want to end up with a run-of-the-mill douchey old gas car when there's such a great big world of options.
Look at you getting all sappy. I guess there's no reason to rush any decision when I don't even know my options yet. I suppose I always thought electric vehicles were these big, complicated machines that only rich people drive.
Come on, be serious. If electric vehicles were only for rich people, do you really think I'd be telling you to get one?
Yeah, whatever. Hey, you gave me my keys back!
Yeah, I said my piece. Can we just sit and listen to music for a bit, for old time's sake?
That sounds perfect.